arm, because you're good at what you do.
So keep in mind, when it comes to wanting your cat pass to look pretty at the bottom, for starters, you gotta make sure that you're practicing and you got it down pat. You gotta make sure that you know how to run a flat B on just regular flat plate. You gotta make sure you know how to do that. You gotta make sure you know what it means to overlap. You get it. And once you get that down pat, next you need to make sure you know how to flow that molted puddle. You know how that molted puddle is flowing. Understand what that puddle is doing. You gotta make sure you're competent in that regard. And whenever you get those couple procedures down pat, now you're ready to make your bottom cap look just like your side or your top or whichever part of your cap that you think that look really good. You want the bottom to match your best side. Again, it's not an intuitive concept. It's more counterintuitive, especially for people who are so used to doing one thing one way and one way only. And it makes sense when you do it, but from the perspective of somebody that's just listening, you might say, man, that's kind of backwards. Why am I pointing this way and going up? Well, check out the clip that I'm about to show you. Pay attention now. And you have to try it for yourself. Okay, try it. And if it worked for you, make sure you let me know. All right? So go for it. Before you tear off and go into practicing and things of that nature, make sure you keep a close arc in that travel angle and that travel speed. Close arc, travel angle, travel speed. Now, right off gates, if you even weld, then you should already know to have your amps on point. Now, if you ask me what do I put my machine on when I'm getting ready to cap, I like to run a 90, 92 amps, 90 to 92. And that's it. Close arc, travel speed, and that angle. Those three things, match them into one, then you get this right here. You get that money. That's what we all want. So yeah, check it out. I'm gonna explain it to you. Watch the clip. So I'm holding the rod this way in the stinger. Now I'm at, this is 5G position pipe. And you can see I'm holding the rod this way. Now when you're on the bottom, this is the way you want to hold the rod. Remember, I'm pointing this way. I'm not going like this right here, as if I'm going up the pipe. I'm holding it this way, as if I'm shooting past the pipe. But as I strike, when I strike my arc, and I'm gonna do upside down C, and I'm gonna go up, 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 until you get about right here. Then you might as well just stop and then change the position and go up. Keep the rod at an angle and go up, 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 upside down C, up, up, up. So you're gonna go from here, doing an upside down C going up, yeah. It's kind of counterintuitive, but this is how you do it. This is how you make a pretty bead at the bottom, coming all the way up. Up, 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 up. Then when you get to a certain angle, you gotta stop, restart, and start going up, 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 up. So for anybody who wanna know, or always try to figure out and couldn't figure it out, that's how you get a pretty bead, nice uniform at the bottom. Now let's look at mine at the bottom. Hopefully you can see it. See that right there? I hope you can see it pretty well, but it ain't got no valleys in it. It's good. I'm trying to get you a good angle, but it's nice and overlapped. Those are two bees. I'm running my second bee. Nice overlap. But yeah, I'm on the bottom. This the top, this the bottom. Yeah. So don't say it can't be done. Shouts out to my boy, you know who you are. Alright. I would shout you out, but I don't know if you're comfortable when you saying your name. But tell Junior I said what's up. Stop sleeping on the job, boy. So the reason why I tell you to hold that rod at that angle, some people may say, well, why should I do that? Why should I hold the rod at this crazy angle where it don't make sense? Well, try holding it the way you intuitively think you should hold it. You realize it's hard to bend your arm and try to have that angle going up and try to keep your arm this way. The way you would imagine you should hold it, at least. So that's why. You want to hold it the opposite direction as if you're shooting past the pipe and walk that cup up, upward. You get it? Simple. Try it. Yeah, it's more than one way to do it. Of course, we all know that. But me personally, I got 21 years this March in the field welding pipe, and that's how I found it to be the easy way for myself. Now, you might have a different technique, and there's always more than one way to do something. Of course, we all know that. So try that technique. Continue to make that money. Practice makes perfect. If you like this information, hey, hit that Cash App for me, and I'll see y'all on the flip side.